Hi, my name's Shawn, and I'm here to talk to you about something that's pretty important as far as health goes. It's electronic cigarettes versus regular cigarettes, and a recent report that was produced by the FDA, things that we all need to be concerned about. I personally just recently started smoking electronic cigarettes. I smoked regular cigarettes for 20 years, just over a pack a day, and now started this unit that you see right here. About 5 days ago, since I started this unit, I have not had a real cigarette since. But of course, with the FDA report that comes out, it's a concern to have. Of course, they're saying that there's cancer toxins in there, which we all know cancer causes death. So it's something to be very aware of that you have right there. First thing that I'd like to tell you is I definitely feel that the FDA should step in on this particular subject and regulate it, just like anything else. What I mean by regulation is putting into those different labels, things that you have of that nature. I'm going to bring this up. Like I said, 5 days ago, I just started smoking this. One supplier sent me this particular product. Now, this is e-juice. What e-juice does, very quickly, if you've never had an electronic cigarette, is it supplies the nicotine. It also supplies the flavor. This is the nuts and bolts of an electronic cigarette. My concern with this is not a child safety cap, and it just says Camel. Now, this is supposed to mimic the Camel cigarette. What if I order this in chocolate? Or anything else, it would have said chocolate on there. If a child walked along and saw this and it said chocolate, they would try it. It has nicotine in it. As we all know, with this much liquid that has nicotine with a child, I'm not educated enough, or excuse me, I should just say I don't have experience enough to really look into what would happen if a child drank all of this, but it's a concern to have. Now, here's the flip side. This is American, this particular one is American based. By the way, this was an American supplier too. This is called Johnson Creek. Johnson Creek, very responsible people that you see right here. Now, this I have added on. It was sent along with, but of course, a child safety cap was on there, so a child couldn't open it. And right here, warning, this product contains nicotine, which is known to be addictive, potentially blah, blah, blah. It has all that stuff in there. Very responsible manufacturer. All right, let's get into the real nuts and bolts about this, and that is the FDA and the thing that was responded, the report that came out. Very quickly for me, I would like to just tell you that I'm too busy with life. I'm just trying to make a living and trying to survive, to go on the net and all these other things and figure out conspiracy theories or whatever alternate options are. One thing that I quickly learned is 5 days in now, I haven't had a real cigarette. I started smoking this. I knew that the FDA ban was out as far as anything foreign being shipped to the United States. I said, man, they're not going to pass this thing. Why, in my opinion? Because anybody who is educated knows money rules the world. And I don't want to get into that right now where I look like that bad guy of, you know, conspiracy theory, but it is, it's true. Politics, a lot of things like that, money is influenced. For me personally, everybody, this gets me along just fine without having a real cigarette. And when you look at that particular tobacco traditional industry, the amount of taxes, things of that nature, this is something that can go either way. So right, wrong, and different, you can look at it that way. But let's look at the facts right now very quickly. Electronic cigarettes are unsafe. They're linked to cancer. Number one, there's not one case that shows that. Number two, this is my big beef about the whole FDA thing. Why wasn't the electronic cigarette compared to a normal cigarette? Why wasn't that target study done? This is what the target study was, everybody. It was compared to a nicotine inhaler. And even then, with the nicotine inhaler, all they did was they did one specific test on it of how much nicotine it had in it. Why that's big is DEG. This is one of the things that propelled it to be brought into the media, CNN, everything else, of electronic cigarettes contain the same thing as antifreeze. Well, that would scare me too. And if I didn't educate myself and take a little bit of time on all of this, I would have been concerned. Well, wait a minute. So you want me to suck on something that's supposed to be an electronic cigarette that contains antifreeze? Of course it turns everybody off. But fact of the matter, everybody, do your homework. DEG, which is what they referenced. Number one, this is an electronic cigarette. Here's your cartridge, your filter that you have right there. 18 different one of these was tested. One of the products contained 1%, if not less, of DEG, that product. I'm not going to go too far down on the road of DEG because I can't verify some of the things I found out, but one thing that I noted about DEG is that it is used to dry tobacco. I don't know if that's true or not, but that can make some different sense that you have right there. But with the DEG, 1%, why wasn't that compared to of a traditional cigarette, which contains a lot more of that in there, and all the other carcinogens that you have? You can't compare something just on its own and say, oh, wait, we found one little thing in this that shows 1%. And a normal tobacco cigarette has thousands of different carcinogens in there, which is bad for us. Here's a simple thing. I've been smoking this for 5 days. In 5 days' time, I now sleep, and I never wake up wanting a cigarette. And unfortunately, after 20 years, I woke up a few times and lit up and had a cigarette. I have more energy. My taste buds are coming back. I'm breathing better. How can you tell me that this is, worse for me? So that is one of the things. Why wasn't that case study done off of a normal cigarette? Number two, May 4th, the study was done. May 5th, we were supposed to have a conference. It didn't happen. Didn't come up until just about now. So were you looking for something that would be wrong with this product? I don't want to sound like, I'm one of those guys, oh, you got to just look at this. But here's a few things I'd like to point out. And this is a normal guy, USA. Number one, why weren't any United States suppliers like Johnson Creek included in the different cartridges that were used? These are responsible manufacturers. This is the only manufactured, I've got them foreign-based. These are the foreign-based ones, China, things of that nature. It doesn't tell me what's inside of them, nothing like that. Here you have Johnson Creek. Man, it tells me the ingredients right there. What's in this? Not only is that, but they were one of the first ones registered with the FDA. But nobody helped them out. Well, I mean, what's going on with that? Here's the other thing. You really want to know about this, everybody? PG is your main component in this. I'm probably going to say it wrong because I'm not a big scientific guy. Propylene glycerol. Here's what's interesting. Propylene glycerol, I saw that, PG. And I just yesterday visited a friend of mine, a chef, and he owns a restaurant. And I was talking to him, and I looked up at this box. And this box had the exact same thing as one of the primary ingredients. And you know what that box was? Snow cones. I've had a few snow cones in my life. So that reinforced things for me as far as the product goes. End of the day, if we're looking at smoking a normal cigarette versus an electronic cigarette, and nobody can nail this thing, because they would have nailed this down to the to the bare boards of something that is not needed, and they couldn't get it. I mean, the cancer, there's no cancer that's been reported, no illnesses, no deaths, things of that nature. I mean, that's what they're saying right now. That's why I label it that way. Causes cancer. Cancer means death. I just don't agree with that. So you have that whole DEG thing, and I really don't understand why that wasn't focused on a little bit more. There is more and more about this if you are a smoker and you really want to know. All I'm going to stick to is what I'm doing right now, and that's my episodes. I just started 5 days ago. FDA came in about this. I was not surprised at all. You got a product here that I'm a smoker 20 years, and if this did not come along, I would have smoked until I died. Now I don't.